EOM Business Network. So much for one broadcast.
Hello there. It's a beautiful day and thank you very much for joining us. You're watching the EOM Business Network, indeed, the voice of corporate Nigeria. I am Olorogo Elkanah Mori. Today on the program, as always, our conversation is to focus on the Nigerian economy. We'll be interfacing with select industry operators about their businesses, the operating environment, and other related issues. Also on the lineup for today is Let's Talk, and our focus is on Platinum Power Planet Limited and Evermark Homes and Properties Limited. On Spot On, we'll bring you Abubakar Usman Gotomo, who is the founder, chairman, and chief executive officer of Gotomo Farms and Allied Services Limited. And on the face-to-face is another industry captain, Maxwell Stephen Nweze, who is the Group Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Seman Global Project Limited, one of the fastest-growing housing and construction companies in Nigeria.
It's a package you must see. Sit back as we bring you the details.
This is BWC Real Estate. BWC Real Estate. Call us now.
Welcome to Farm Funds Africa. Farm Funds Africa. Call us now. We are called Lekki Swiss Property Development Limited. Lekki Swiss Properties Development Limited. Real estate, building construction, land survey, land clearing, property development, stone-coated roofing, and many more. Lekki Swiss Properties Development Limited. What can be imagined can be achieved. Hip, 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 hooray! Happy birthday, the board, management, and staff of Lekki Swiss Properties Development Limited. Felicitate Mrs. Adobe Ukpai, the Executive Director of Lekki Swiss Properties Development Limited, on the auspicious occasion of your birthday. We ask that God Almighty grant you long life, great health, and prosperity. Signed, Dr. Ude Ukpai, Chief Executive Officer, Lekki Swiss Properties Development Limited.
I just want to say thank you to God Almighty for making me see today, making today a reality. It's not by my power, not by my might, but I just give glory to God for making it possible for me and my entire family to be celebrating today as my day. So generally, I just want to give thanks.
Love my mother. Everything she has done for us until today is the greatest mommy ever, and nobody can replace her.
My mommy is beautiful, and she's the best mommy in the whole wide world. I just want to thank her for doing everything that she has done. Happy birthday, Mom.
My wife, Mrs. Adobe Udelbai, has been a gift from above. I call her Oluwa Designer. I see it's just like a gift from God. And God perfected it the way I wanted it to be. She's always there for me. And they say the backbone of every man. So she's doing very well in my life.
She's my mom. I've been with them since my childhood till now. She's the best I've ever seen so far, and the other way around, I'm just saying happy birthday to her.
I want to use this opportunity to wish my boss wife a very big happy birthday.
Today is a special day. One of our directors celebrating her birthday. I wish her long life and good health.
A happy and a prosperous, wonderful birthday wishing her long life and prosperity because she's a very good mother, very good wife to our MD.
Madam Adobe Obai is a special blessing to the whole family. We can't exchange her for anything else. She's adorable, she's loving, and she's a kind woman.
They said behind every successful man, there's always a woman. So she is one of them. And I wish her happy birthday today.
Things have taught me a lot. But in all, I would just say, like my husband always say, that I should be myself. Love has taught me to be myself, not to be like anyone else, but just myself.
Mrs. Dorcas Omamuli is the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Farm Funds Africa.
That's the best thing that has happened to this country. The closure of the border is the best thing that has happened to this country. And I sincerely hope that they leave it close till we are now 100% ready to face that border. And when we are facing that border, when it's open, we'll be facing it with a different mindset, in the sense that we will not be thinking to eat the junk that might be coming from there. Rather, we'll be thinking of how to take our things out to bring back good money. Now, before the border closure, we all eat foreign rice. We thought it was the best thing that happened to us, even though I never liked it. My peer can attest to that. I call it cow rice, because I feel that those people over there abroad, we go abroad, they don't eat it. Those rice they bring to us, they don't eat it. They eat basmati rice. So, but when they're bringing those rice, they bring it here for us to eat. Why are they giving us what they are not eating? Like, you know? So I think they use it to feed their cow and they're not bringing it to us to eat. So I didn't like it. So, but thank God, I was more into the basmati and the ofada rice. When the border was closed, I'm like, okay, what do we want to eat now? Is it that our stony rice? How are we going to survive? Oh my God, it's going to be difficult to pick and to, you understand? I didn't even know that we could do stone, we could polish, we could do all that. We didn't have a choice. That's why it was very expensive. It will still come down. We're going to crash the market. We're working hard to crash that market of rice so that it will no longer be expensive. So that's why I say we're not ready for the border yet. Once our rice becomes maybe 5,000 per bag, then we can open the border. At that point, with this very good rice that is healthy, do you want to go and buy their rice? You won't want to.
Ojelade Rotimi Bola is the managing partner of CWP Consultants.
We don't do actual construction. What we do is advising people that want to do development, managing construction projects. I will say that in terms of competence, almost everybody we've worked with recognize that we bring superior knowledge and competence to the table in the industry. And that's one of our unique selling proposition. Apart from that, we also have innovative ways of approaching issues. Now, there are traditional ways you go about things, but we don't really think within the traditional box. We think outside of the box. We work with our clients more like our partners, as partners, not just as clients. So we work with them from the cradle of the project, from even the concept development, from raising funds, from helping them to structure partnership. That's what we've been doing. A lot of traditional consulting practices don't do that. They just do their, or if you're an architect, you design, you collect your money and you go. If you're a quant surveyor, you provide your quant surveying services and then you collect your money and go. But we work more as partners with our clients and we bring a lot of resourcefulness and innovation to the table. Currently, we have about 4 projects running. They are relatively new. We're advising a developer, Octify Development Company, on the real estate project in Karimo here. So for that, we're rendering both the quantity surveying, project management, and other advisory services. Currently, we're also, now, the one that is of great interest to me is we're advising the federal government on FCDA, that's Federal Capital Development Authority, on structuring a public-private partnership on multi-level car parks in the city. Because, and that started sometimes last year. We did parking studies across the city, especially within the metropolis, and we discovered that there are a lot of places that has parking problems, especially when you go to a place like Mitama, around I-Court, CAC, ETF, WAHEC. You see that the entire streets are messed up by cars parking on the street. So it's an eyesore. Now we're helping FCDA to build a business case to attract private investors to come and invest in parking.
CWP Consultants.
If it is about estate developers, realtors, and builders, then it must be Semang Global Project Limited. Semang Global Project Limited. Call us now. James Akimbade is the manager at Platinum Power Planet Limited.
Platinum Power Planet is a limited liability company that is incorporated in Nigeria. We deal with the sales, installation, and maintenance of solar and renewable energy because we see a huge market in the solar company and we decide to tap into it because of the abundance of the natural resources. We've been on ground since 2009 when we started, but we didn't start as Platinum Power Planet. We started at Will 711 Communication then. Then we are more into communications, and later we now graduated into Platinum Power Planet. The vision of Platinum Power Planet Limited is to create a brand name that will be the leading name in renewable energy company in Nigeria when it comes to renewable energy. And our mission is to make our products affordable for all and sundry at the least affordable prices so that most of the people in Nigeria can afford to tap into renewable energy. And so far so good, we've been able to power a lot of homes, offices with renewable energy, and a lot of people are keen into it now. About Platinum Power Planets, our products are top-notch quality products. We import our products from Europe and America, most especially because you know battery is the life of renewable energy anywhere in the world. And the battery lifespan of our products is around 7 years. So we try to tap into the best quality products in the market. And our services have been so outstanding because a lot of clients that have actually key into it from us have been having good memories about it. Renewable energy is an alternative source of power in the sense that it's been tapped from the natural sources, which is from sunlight, from the wind, from the water. And a lot of people doesn't really know this. And because, you know, it's unlike the generator sets of that uses fossil fuels. Renewable energy uses sunlight to tap energy that can generate power for your homes. So that means independently, as a company or as a business, as a household, you can generate your own power by yourself without depending on the national grid. So renewable energy is the next phase of energy that will have to key into Nigeria, because it is the future of the world, no matter what, and it gives you comfort. So it's just natural, because we see this sunlight every day is being wasted by so many places, so many companies, especially we have abundant of it in Nigeria. So we just have to tap into it. And that is what the renewable energy is all about. It's an energy that you renew by yourself. You have the self-control over it. Just like we have boreholes in many homes now. Nobody depends on the National Water Board anymore. You create water by yourself, so you can also create your home power by yourself and generate power. We've been doing a lot to reach out to the federal government and to the state governments so that they can create alternative power for most of the, maybe in the rural areas and also in the urban areas as well. In the aspect of reaching out to the government, we've sent a lot of representatives to the government, and we thank God at least they are keen into it now. Because if you go to Ministry of Power in Mabushi now, it's being powered by the solar grid. It's there for everybody to see. I can see a lot of solar street lights being installed in so many streets and so many areas now. These are government works. If you go to NDDC, the Nigeria NIDA Delta, you see a lot of projects being powered by solar. See solar balls being installed in so many local governments.
If it is about solar, inverter, battery, CCTV, and electric fence, then it must be Platinum Power Planet Limited. Platinum Power Planet Limited. Independent, sustainable, and optimum power supply, always. we are called Red Oak Trust and Investment Limited. Israel Adekunle Ibrahim is the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Evermark Homes and Properties Limited.
Evermark Homes and Properties Limited has been in system for over 3 years now. Glory to God, we've been able to create a lot of landlords and then make positive impacts in the real estate sector. One of the core missions of Evermark Homes and Properties is to create affordable housing for individuals and to create luxury real estate at its best that's going to make our clients thoroughly satisfied and come back for more. Our core values is to make our clients really, really and thoroughly satisfied and then to make the management more happy and then to achieve our goals. That's the core values that we have. Over the years, Evermark Homes and Properties has been able to create a lot of landlords, like I said earlier. Over now, we've been able to create more than 1,000 landlords in my team in houses, and then also in land and properties, we've been able to create more than 4,000 of landowners right in Lagos. And also, we've been able to sell a lot of houses over the years. And then also, currently now, we are still selling lands and properties also. The name of the asset that we sold, actually, we sold that was Bella Homes. We sold houses at Bella Homes, sold at Creekview, we sold at Taniji in Abuja, and also we sold houses in Sokoto, we sold in Ondo State. So we have all our partners all around the country and globe because we have a network them together. We have a platform whereby we have our consultants, we have team members abroad, both in Chicago, we have a lot of clients abroad, we have in Lagos, we have in all across the 36 states because we have a network whereby we have the database of all these people. When your clients are thoroughly satisfied, they will definitely tell each other about your product. So that is why we said our core values, one of the major core values of us is to make our client thoroughly satisfied. And then this pandemic has really helped us because this pandemic, we were unable to reach out to a lot of people and do some marketing, but our referrals actually speak louder for us because we did more and then we created more land and property owners during this pandemic than ever before. It's really amazing. And then most of our clients are from diaspora, and then few from Nigeria.
You are onto Evermark Homes and Properties Limited. Oh yes, Evermark Homes and Properties Limited. Real estate development, real estate investment, real estate marketing, real estate management. Evermark Homes and Properties Limited. You can call us now. Abubakar Usman Gotomo, who is a member of the Nigerian Institute of Public Relations, is the founder, chairman, and chief executive officer of Gotomo Farms and Allied Services Limited.
First and foremost, you have to score the government very, very high, even though they are just doing what is traditionally being done globally, because we have some peculiarities. So, but we merely adopted whatever other countries are adopting. But I commend them. Governments acted fast, put task force in place, give the task force the support that they needed to do the work, and also state key into this. Maybe that's what perhaps reduced the level of the excess positive cases in the country. But as I said, we have our peculiarities here. Here you have a people who have no saving culture, majority, many of Nigerians. In fact, what is there to save? You save when you have excess. So people are largely living hand to mouth, and they have to go out daily for them to get. So when you prolong the lockdown, you expect a devastating effect beside from that of COVID-19. And you also stand the risk of having public reaction, the mass reaction when you continue to do that. So that's why I say government could have devised a means and employing something that can respond to our cultural realities. So in this respect, my own preposition or recipe for government is to continue to intensify. It is a public health issue, so to intensify of education, mobilizing, enlightening people on how to take precautions, how to protect themselves. Principally, the hand washing, the mask wearing, limiting the gathering of public. So all these governments should impose and emphasize on that, but allow people to come out and look for their daily bread. Otherwise, anything will stop. Now you combine banditry, insecurity with lockdown. Then what result do you think you are expecting? Production stopped, the fear of insecurity, and lockdown. It's equal to what? Chaos and death. Chaos and more death. Because those with underlying issues, aside from the COVID, the risks.
To Gotomo Farms and Allied Services Limited. Gotomo Farms and Allied Services Limited. Sesame seeds, ginger, cashew nuts, sunflower, rice, cassava, oil seeds, hibiscus, moringa leaves, and many more. Go to Mo Farms and Allied Services Limited. Call us now.
Welcome to Seman Global Project Limited, a member of Seman Group of Companies. Seman Group of Companies is a Nigerian chain of businesses which commenced operation in 2016 with the view of delivering world-class services in real estate development, building, construction, superstores, and project management, amongst others. Seman Global Project Limited has since emerged as a formidable and enviable construction company from its position as a leading player in the Nigerian real estate and property development sector. This enviable achievement is attributable to the dedication and commitment of the company to its vision, mission, integrity, and high-quality offerings over the years. Seman Group boasts of well-trained and ethical specialists, as well as experienced professionals, project managers, architects, structural engineers, civil engineers, quantity surveyors, and interior designers, with a combined experience base that covers other associated civil works and construction. The company's aim is to develop high-value projects and long-term growth for its investors, end users, and communities. Maxwell Stephen Nweze is the Group Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Seman Group of Companies.
Seman Global Project Limited is an indigenous company that has been driven by passion to contribute its quote on housing deficit in Nigeria. And we are engaged in other different business. We are into importation, we are into transport, we are into real estate as well. The vision and the mission of Seman Global Project Limited is one, providing affordable housing for all, and through our platform, making sure that low-income earners were able to get and access housing easily in FCT or Nigeria at large. And by God's willing, we're able to achieve at least 20% of it. Core values of Seman Global Project Limited is integrity in all our transactions, making sure that our clients are satisfied with our products and services. We have been able to deliver some estate. We have a side view estate located at Airport Road by Voice of Nigeria, sitting on 10 hectares of land, fully built, and currently people are staying in it. We have Garden City, fully built, people are living in it. We have Side View Phase 2, fully built, people are in it currently. We are developing one of the largest estates within the Airport Road, sitting on 260 hectares of land, or Sima Metropolis. The project is ongoing, and we are doing everything possible to make it a success. Actually, not 100%, but at least I can give them 70. They're actually doing their best to ensure that the activities of real estate developers has been achieved in FCT and in Nigeria at large. COVID-19 is a global pandemic. Generally, it has brought the activities of businesses very slow, not on real estate alone, but generally in all businesses. You find out that things are not going the way it should be, and we are not exceptional, but we are taking it slow and steady. It's not coming as it should be, but we are moving gradually. The Nigerian government, they are doing their best as they could. I would say personally that their best is not good enough. They should educate the public more on how to stop the spread of COVID-19 and let them be able to tell us the necessary things to be done, not playing politics with it. This has to do with health, and the wealth of every nation is how healthy their citizens are. So we must have to take it as number one and make sure that the government need to do the needful to enlighten the masses, educate them the more, let them sanitize people very well on how to manage the situation. I think it will go a long way.
Surveyors are actually scientists, and most time what really interests them is what they wanted to do.
The border closure have put an end to the smuggling of frozen chicken.
What effort are we making in solving this looming population challenge?
I never thought of doing door-to-door before, and then the lockdown allowed us to do that.
The middle class is the market now.
The majority of this housing, in terms of management, they are stuck in the hand of quacks.
Well, and that's a beautiful place to call it a wrap on today's package of the EOM Business Network. Thank you very much for spending your precious time with us. We do not take it for granted. But just in case you missed out on any aspect of it, then you can come with us to our feedback handles on the screen. Our sincere gratitude to you, our sponsors, for your continued interest and support. Always remember, with you and us, we are charms. Oh yes, I remain Olorogu Elkanah Moari. Please, let's do this again, same time, same channel, next week. We'll see you then.